What's going on, guys? Red Rhino Music here, bringing you another video. Today we're hopping on that Forza Horizon 2, just because I wanted to play a Horizon style game before Forza Horizon 3 comes out next month. If you can hear my air conditioner or like my fan in the background, I apologize, but it's hot as hell in this room, so I need it. Basically, it's late at night right now, and I just felt like hopping on this game to cruise around and drift around a little bit. Now let me just put a disclaimer out here. I am not good at drifting. I'm not saying I'm good at drifting. I just felt like trying it, you know? Like, I like the idea of drifting. So sometimes I'll convince myself that I can do drifting, and I will try it. Which is what this video is going to be. I also just wanted to talk about, like, Forza Horizon 3, like, a couple things in that. But this was mostly just to drive around on here. Anyways, I've always wanted to get better at drifting. Like, especially on Forzas. I remember back on Midnight Club LA, I got pretty good at it. But that's like a completely different type of game. Like, it feels nothing alike. I'm pretty sure you couldn't even change like traction control or anything in that game, but I don't know. I think when I played that game, I didn't even know what traction control was. I was like 10. But I never like really bothered to put in the time to learn how to drift. Like, it's something I'm going to be doing for like a little while until Horizon 3 comes out. Because in that game, I'd like to do some cool videos of like me and my friends drifting and doing stuff like that. Like, I want to do a lot of like group content for that game. Like, I always talk about how I want to do group stuff, but it's hard because not everybody gets on at the same time. And then we gotta like stay focused on like the task of filming something, but I also don't want to like have to make people do things, you know. I don't know, but on that game, it would be cool to do some like tandem drifting sessions and stuff like that. It's also hard to drift because I don't know how to set up like a drift car. Like this Mercedes I have right here, I have like, I threw like all the way negative camber on the front. I don't really know why. Like, I just messed around with settings in the tuning menu. Like, I could tune a regular car to go like fast and handle good. But I don't know how you're supposed to set up a car to drift. I did lock the differential quite a bit. I think I raised the tire pressure too. And that's about it. I think I shortened the gears also, so it's more aggressive, so it slides easier. And then the other problem is I can't download somebody's tuning setup because I have a wheel and things are completely different between the controller and the wheel. So like what you do with your thumb on the control stick, I'm using a controller right now, but because I didn't feel like pulling the wheel out at like 1 in the morning. But the difference is, like, would you move your thumb left and right with, I have to do that with my arms and turn it 900 degrees, which is, like, quite a bit of turning. Maybe if I had a bigger rim on the wheel, it would be easier, but those are quite the dollar. So who knows? Plus, it's, like, especially after, like, the past couple weeks where I had to, like, try to fix the wheel, pretty scary to try to drift with it because I feel like it's gonna break. Like, I'm pretty sure I could handle it. There's people with the wheel that drift online and stuff, and I think that's like a common use of the wheel, so I guess it could handle it, but I just don't trust it. I'm not saying the quality of the wheel is bad. I'm saying, like, I'm a damn brute and I'm gonna break the thing. Well, anyways, what I was talking about before with, like, Horizon 3, I just wanted to talk about a couple cool cars that they're adding to the game that are new to, like, the Horizon series. Well, I think they're new to the whole game in general. But the first one, I'll put pictures of them, too. The first one's a 1974 Holden Sandman HQ panel van. To me, it looks more like a hearse than a panel van, but it is Australian, so I guess it's built off of, like, a ute platform. Or a UTE, I don't know what you're supposed to call them. I'm going to call it a Gute if you have a problem. That's tough. Then the next cool car is the 1971 Myers Manx, which if you go and bring a trailer, which is like an eBay Motors for cars that don't suck, they have a bunch of them on there. Like, as since they announced this thing to be in the game, a bunch of people have been selling them, so I don't know what the deal is with that. I don't know if it's a coincidence or if, like, whoever runs that website goes and looks for cars that are just being mentioned in, like, Forza and stuff. Like, it's like the day that they announced this car in the game, I've seen, like, three of those things posted on there. Alright, well, the next car is the 2011 Penhall Chola, which is a, I guess it's a Baja racer or something like that. I don't know what you would call one of these. I'm not that big into, like, off-roading stuff. But this thing looks pretty cool. It's something new to the game. They released a gameplay video today, I think. There was one the other day, but now there's one today. And it was like 30 minutes long. And it was a creator of the game, and then like that, I forget his name, the bald dude that does all these Xbox events. It was him and that guy playing the game, and they were talking about like how they had to work to figure out how to do the suspension on this thing. Which is pretty cool. The next thing is the 1979 Toyota FJ40, which is, you know, these things are damn durable. They always talk about these things on, like, Top Gear and stuff. The next thing, I think I saw it on Top Gear, and if I didn't see it on Top Gear, I saw it on a YouTube car review channel. The 2016 Aerial Nomad. This thing is badass. So if you played, like, Forza or watched, like, Top Gear or whatever, you've probably seen the Aerial Atom, because it's a fast-ass little frame on wheels with some seats in it. This is basically the off-roading version of that, which is even cooler, in my opinion. Next is the 2015 Ford Falcon XR8, which I guess is the Australian version of the Fusion, which I drive a Fusion, not this generation, but like the one before, with the big chrome on the front. I like these things. Like, if I had money, because I like my car. I like my car a lot. But if I had money, I would have to take a boat over to Australia and ship this thing back over here. Because this thing is badass. It's like the Ford Fusion, but it's the Falcon, so it's the Australian version. And it has a big-ass V8 in it. Like all Australian cars do, so you know how they get down. Then continuing with Ford over here, we got the 2014 Ford FPV, which is Ford Performance Vehicle, limited edition Pursuit Ute. This thing looks cool as hell. That's all I pretty much have to say about it. They don't show the front or anything, but I assume it looks exactly like the last car. And if it doesn't, it looks like the Ford Falcon, I want to say FG. I don't really know the names of those things. There's one that has like black decals on the front or plastic. I can't tell what it is. I've only seen a couple pictures of them. But those are pretty cool. And then the last one I want to talk about is the 2015 Polaris RZR, or Razor, I guess, XP 1000. This thing, well, Polaris makes like ATVs and stuff like that. And like hunting vehicles, I guess you'd call them. They use them on like farms and stuff. They're like golf carts with a back, like a pickup truck. This is basically one of those. I assume this is a much faster one. And I cannot wait to drive this because it's cool. It's part of their new short wheelbase cars that I think that they've been working on. Because they've added that. They've added the BMW Isetta. And I think a couple other things, but they were talking about, I think they were talking to Matt Farah about it, how they wanted to like add short wheelbase cars to the game, or like three wheel cars and stuff like that. So I guess this is part of that ordeal. Anyways, that's basically all I wanted to talk about. It's late and I felt like making a video. I'm gonna go watch the UFC fights tomorrow night. Well, I guess by the time this is uploaded, tonight. So I'm excited for that. That's all. I just wanted to hop on in here and make a video real quick. As for other videos, I don't really know. I want to do a couple other things on Horizon. Maybe get back on Motorsport a little bit. I also want to do a little Project Cars. I was having fun with that. Like last week or whatever. Anyways, thanks for watching. Thanks for coming to listen to me babble on about nothing over here. I'll see you next time. I'm out.